Hi there, drummers and drum fans. This is Bazybeats coming to you on video from Tampa Bay. And today we're at Digital Music Services in Tampa, Florida. And we're with Brian Hendrickson, who is the owner, producer, and engineer here at the studio. Brian, I'm going to ask you some questions because there's drummers out there that are going to be coming in to their first time at the studio, and there's important things they need to know. You and I had some conversations earlier, so I'd like to hit on some of the more important topics that we discussed. When we were talking about what should you be thinking about prior to coming into the studio, you had a lot of great ideas of things that you should think about bringing with you. Could you go over some of those things that you should that are essential to have in the studio when you come?
Well, some of the things I would recommend to our drummers to bring would be, obviously, spare heads, drum key or two, duct tape, a Sharpie, plenty of sticks, including a set of brushes and perhaps some different thicknesses of sticks for different styles of songs they're going to be recording. And that's pretty much the basics there.
And you had said brushes too, and because sometimes you're playing songs that require a really soft touch, and if you're using baseball bats like 5A's or something like that, then you're going to get a really heavy sound, and that's not really what you want. So it's okay to bring brushes into the studio.
Absolutely. I would recommend that you bring a variety of brushes and sticks as much as you can, because that way you're prepared for any situation on any part that you're going to be playing in different types of material.
And you talked about new heads. Why new heads?
New heads are going to sound a lot better than the heads that you've been beating on for the past 2 or 3 weeks. If at all possible, I would recommend using a set of hydraulic heads, perhaps like Evans, and putting them on at least 24 hours in advance, putting some tension on them, and allowing them time to stretch so that when you actually get to the studio, you can come in, set your kit up, and then actually get them tuned up and ready to go.
Pretty quickly, yeah, because one of the really important factors to the studio, and I can tell you from my experiences, is time is money. It doesn't matter if it's your band or you coming in to record something for yourself, or if you're hired by some other artist to come in and lay drum tracks, time is of essence, right?
Exactly. Our flat rate here is $80 an hour, and I know some of the larger studios in the country charge anywhere from $150 to up to $350 per hour.
Wow. So again, every minute counts in this environment. So having the right stuff, drum keys and extra pair of sticks. A lot of electronic drummers, they don't go through sticks. So they think, well, I don't need to take an extra pair of sticks to a gig. I don't need to take an extra pair of sticks to the studio because I've been using the same pair of sticks for 2 years. Myself, I think I'm on one pair of sticks for 3 years now with the electronic kit. And so you think, well, I don't need to bring them. But the fact is, you never know when Mother Nature is going to say it's time for the stick to break. Or, it gets warped, or God only knows what. Maybe one stick gets out the window of the car somehow, or gets lost, or wet, or something, and you need another stick.
Absolutely.
So you don't want to waste time and having to go stop the production to go off-site, to go to like a music store or something, and looking for something that you need. That's time that's running, correct?
Correct.
So if I came into your studio and I needed something, I left, you know, you're still sitting here, it's your time, it's your money. Someone's going to have to pay that bill.
Absolutely. We don't stop running the clock unless the session's over with and you go home for the evening. And you certainly don't want to be the one responsible solely for holding up the recording session.
Right. Okay, so in keeping with that in mind, basically, about time is money in the studio environment, what about spare heads and stuff like that? You talk about having heads and getting the new ones and coming in, but what about not just spare sticks, but heads? You talked about that.
Absolutely. You want to make sure you have at least one spare head for every tom, including the kick drum, because regardless of the fact that you just put new heads on there, you can break a head, and if you're recording on a weekend or a holiday and your local music store is closed, you can find yourself literally putting the session in entirety to a complete stop simply because you don't have a spare head to change and continue on with the session.
We talked a little bit about pre-production as well, and pre-production is time that you spend studying the music or studying whatever you're going to come into the studio and do prior to coming in. Now, what does that do for you?
Well, basically, you want to make sure that you have your parts memorized, any recent changes in your pieces that have been altered, already adjusted for. You want to make sure that you have everything done when you come in. You don't want to be coming in and learning parts or figuring out changes when you're paying anywhere from $100 to $350 an hour. It's a very costly experience.
That's so true. That's so true. And on to top on to that is that not only should you be prepared with the right music and know what you're going to do, but mentally and physically to prepare yourself, you should probably get some good rest.
Absolutely. You want to make sure when you get in there that you have the ability to focus correctly. Coming in exhausted, tired from working two jobs, a night of partying before, anything that's going to break your lack of concentration is going to take more time. And again, as you had stated earlier, Basie, time is money in the studio.
Time is money. Well, that's going to conclude the first segment of this video. I'm going to go ahead and say this now, that you can, if you want more information directly from Digital Music Services on studio time or any of the information that we provided in the video today, you can find it here at the bottom of the screen. You can get their email and their web address. In the meantime, there will be another video following this one to finish up this segment. Thanks, and until the next time, have a good night.